Alright, good morning, good afternoon, good evening sa ating mga viewers from the Middle East. Alright, so Saudi Arabia, UAE, Qatar, especially yung ating core of the viewers from the Philippines. And I'd like to greet out especially yung mga viewers natin from South Korea and Singapore who has been steadily increasing, right, for the last, I think, 3 weeks. And a quick update lang, guys. I don't know if you have already know it. Yung isa sa mga ginagamit natin, yung PSE tools, is already taken down due to regulatory issues, I think. And at this point in time, we are only down to Investagrams para sa ating third-party charting. And I think we have to thank yung Investagrams for pursuing yung ganitong mission. Because malaki din yung naitutulong sana if we have both yung PSE tools and we have yung Investagrams, because may kanya-kanya silang features. Alright, so again, we're going to look into some of the position that we might be interested, right? And looks interesting bagamat we have a recent pull down by the market. Alright, so before we do all of that, let's have yung ating weekly quick word from the sponsor. Alright, so this comes from Chronicles. Alright, so medyo mahababa, but it goes and read like this: if I shut up the heavens so that there is no rain, or if I command the locusts to devour the land, or if I send pestilence among my people, and my people who are called by my name humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven, and I'll forgive their sin, and will heal their land. 2 Chronicles chapter 13, verse 14. Alright, so I'd like to show you, no, yung isa sa mga ways or signature moves of God. Right, so no rain, right, so nagpapadala siya ng pestilence and locust. Right, so napakapasaway kasi ng tao. Right, so ang maganda naman dito, once we repent and we pray with an honest heart, binabaliktad niya naman yan. So pinapaulan niya, and then inaalis niya yung locus. So bakit ko ba na-share sa inyo to? Recently, if you have been viewing, right, and I'd like yung input sa mga Middle East countries, right, so recently, I think yung Saudi Arabia, nagkaroon sila ng locust infestation, I think sa Mecca pa yata. Guys, confirm ba to? Or this is a fake news? Right? I think this is the first time din na nangyari yun sa kanila. And this is very, very alarming. Right? So, could someone at least, no, from the Middle East confirm kung binabalita ba yan sa kanila? Sa inyo, yung mga local news dyan, yung locust swarm na nangyari, I think recently lang. Alright, so again, I want you guys to read the Bible, because this is not a history book. There are things na bound to happen na nandito, and if you are looking for the truth, no other book but this book, no, the Bible. And hopefully you are already starting to read the Bible, no. So medyo nakakabahala lang because of the recent development, because as we all know, that is a signature move of God, no, yung pagpapadala ng locust, yung saan kinakain yung mga farm or mga plants na tanim, right? So again, that is our quick word from the sponsor, and let's now move on sa ating mga watch list. Right, so itong watch list natin, today we will be using yung Investagrams already. So I think I am already looking to transfer as well dito sa Investagrams. I think magkaroon lang ng kalinawan kung matutuloy na sila sa kanilang brokers. Right, so again, lahat ng mga sasabihin ko dito would definitely not 100%, and do not rely, no, sa mga sasabihin ko lang. You should investigate, and you should be diligent enough to put in your entries and exit, right? So medyo last week it was a mixed market. We have a bullish from the early week, and then biglang baba nung during the end of the 2 days, no? And one of our watch lists is Mega World, right? So what we can see, right? So it's a triple top, no? One, we have touched the resistance here. We have two, and successfully broken yung pangatlo. All right, so do we buy, right? The good area to buy is 495, no? Dito sa area na to, 495 to 505. I think it's currently priced at 5, and from what we can see, right? So we are trying to accumulate on those areas, no? So parang Abacor during the start of the randa, Abacor nagti-triple top siya. Pero ito naman iba kasi may ano na siya, may kalabang ka dito unlike sa Abacor na triple top siya pero 52 week high. All right. So yun yung accumulation area, and I think ating partial taking of profit is yung 530, etong area na to, itong green line na to, and another partial profit dito sa 550, right? That is our target for Mega World. So maganda yung recent development sa Mega World. If you have not yet been reading the news, meron silang project yung Vion Tower sa Makati, which I think ito yung kanilang flagship, and they are hoping and they are looking to be the leader, no, pagdating diyan sa area na yan, no, with their flagship tower. All right. So again, that is our take for Mega World. Again, try to accumulate on those areas, and I do not think na magrarally nang dire-diretso to. But at least, no, you don't come magstick sa area na yon at that support, because maganda, magandang support yan, medyo matibay-tibay yan. So that is our take for Abacor. Again, our charts, kung medyo naninibago kayo, this is from Investagrams, alright? So next on our watch list would be Abacor Holdings. Alright, so Abacor Holdings, so mapapansin natin, there is already resistance at this area. Medyo mabigat na yan, medyo nakikita nyo yung candles, medyo malalaki na. And if you are doing a trend following dito, you might want to lighten your position. Alright? So again, AVA remains to be the stock to beat. Alright? So sa ating stock market. And I think at this point in time, you might play defensive and start to lighten your position. And if not, kung hindi ka pa naman nakakabili, you might want to check and buy dito sa area na to, itong green line na to. That is a good intermediate support. That is, I think, 0.64. And at this point in time sa market, we might be and dapat tayo maging defensive at this point in time because of the recent global news na nangyayari sa atin. And definitely dito ma-i-implement yung ating mga defensive style or position, no? So aba, yan yung mga nakikita natin na medyo active pa rin sa mga market. Next on our watch list, medyo bagong development to, etong Vita, no? Pagdating sa Vita, I think nag-uumpisa pa lang yung rally, and it's currently facing yung resistance, no, at this area, and you might want to at least stay on the sidelines and let's try to observe at least for 3 days if mabibreak niya tong area na to, right? Etong, I think this is 208, dapat maglaro-laro lang siya dyan. 208 or 205, no? So para sa ating Vita, so ang ating first target, if makaka-position tayo diyan, if for 3 days medyo gumanda at nag-ano siya rito, nag-consolidate, we might want to check and see and try if we could check yung ating first profit sa 230 area. Itong area na to, that is a good profit zone, and again yung isa pa nating bitaw dito sa 250. So maganda sa Vita, this is a recent development, and maganda yung pinapakitang volume, no, dito sa Vita Corporation. So baka umpisa pa lang to, And let's try to observe kung mabibreak niya muna itong level na ito, because this is a considerable resistance, right? Alright, next on our watch list would be JGS, who has been recently, no? So mapapansin mo nga lang dito sa JGS, although maganda yung activity and value turnover, medyo extended na rin, alright? Medyo extended na yung kanyang movement. And at this point in time, with the current market situation na hindi pa natin malaman kung ano yung nangyayari, we might want to check and see for a retest, no? Around this 60 area, no? So last week, if you are following, no, ang sabi natin, you might want to check and see yung mabibreak niya yung 60. Nabreak niya nga yung 60. But yun nga lang, with the recent market development, I do not think na baka mag, it might go for a retest, no? So baka maipit ka rito sa itaas. I think it's wise at this point in time na bumili rito sa 60 area and wait for a retest. Baka bumaba siyang pag ganun before finally moving, no? Again, ang overall sentiment dito sa JGS is very bullish with the recent development, alright, sa ating sa mga ano eh, sa mga nanalo during the new Clark International Airport. And I think at this point in time, I do not think na magdedire-diretso itong rally niya. I think, no, definitely it will go for a retest tong JGS. Right, so ating JGS, that is our take for JGS. This has been a laggard, no? Even nung bull market last year, isa to sa mga laggard. But right now, it's doing a good job of climbing up, no? Itong JGS, and we might want to check and see kung ma-re-retest itong 60, that is a good buy area to accumulate. And at this point in time, medyo extended na yung movement ng JGS, you might want to take profit and lighten your position, right? So kung trip na trip nyo talaga to, dagdag na lang kayo dito sa 60 area, right? So pagdating na 60 area, eto na, and ma-retest, eto na yung next na target natin dito sa area na itong green, no? Again, compare ko lang yung PSE tools or Chupetot, that is a very good app para sa mga on the go, kasi ako, I do a lot of traveling. While ito namang Investagrams, is kompleto naman siya with all of the tools and neat features niya, no? So, maganda sana kung magagamit natin yung dalawa. But currently, we are already down to Investagrams na lang. And guys, I'd like to see your comment kung meron kayong ibang ginagamit na app or mga tools or website na kung saan kayo nagcha-charting, you might want to share sa others, no, para makita din natin kung saan kayo nagpa-plot ng inyong mga charts. Alright, so guys, tulungan tayo. You might want to suggest kung saan kayo kumukuha or nagagawa ng inyong mga charting sessions. Right? So next on our watch list would be CHP. Again, CHP, if na-view mo last week, ang sabi natin dito, you try to check and see if mabibreak niya yung 2. Alright, so na-break niya nga yung 2. Eventually, running up dun sa 220. But nag-fade siya, no? At bumabalik ulit siya sa around 2 peso level. At this point in time, I think this is a healthy pullback. Right? So I think this is only a healthy pullback. And medyo delikado lang, no? Once this 2 peso level is mabreak, no, dapat at least for the next few days ma-hold niya tong 2 peso level so that we could clearly see na medyo healthy pullback lang siya. And if not, medyo delikado tayo, right? But kung medyo mataas yung position mo, you might want to trim and cut your losses at this point in time. But if you have been nakabili ka naman sa 2 peso or around dyan sa area na yan, huwag kang masyadong kaban. I think this is a retest lang ng support, no? Kasi ang problema sa mga downtrend na ganito, once nagkaroon ng overall timpla, nagbago yung market from bullish, tapos medyo nag-hesitation, eto namang mga downtrend and talagang unang mga tinatamaan. Alright, so we're seeing definitely nervousness for the swing and day traders. So for the last 3 days pababa siya. And no, I think no, if you are very bullish dito sa CHP, you might want to check and see if ma-hold niyo yung 2 peso for the next trading days. If not baka it might revisit yung 1.90. But overall, I'm still bullish dito sa CHP because from what I see sa charts, this is a start of a reversal. Yun nga lang, medyo nagkaroon ng bagong timpla yung market. And ito, yung isa sa mga tinamaan din ng ano. So if 2 peso will hold yung ating initial, take profit, tulad nga ng sinasabi ko, is around dito sa area na to, itong 240. So that is a good area to buy. And yung susunod nating na take profit zone, medyo malayo-layo na, which is around or 290 to 3 peso. So ang kagandahan naman dito sa CHP, medyo kung may oras ka, medyo i-try and follow mo lang, and malaki naman yung risk to reward. Gandahan mo na lang yung entries mo sa CHP. Right? So maganda naman dito, isa pa sa mga dahilan kung bakit bumaba to, sell on news, because there's a recent article na mga lumabas about the two plants na nag-resume, and then nagkaroon ng secure ng loans para sa kanilang operation. And I think for a long-term view, that is a good sign. At least medyo gumaganda yung fundamentals ng company, right, sa CHP. And that is our take for CHP, and be very, very defensive din dito sa CHP. Because talaga na sinabi ko, pagka ganyan nagkakaroon ng bagong timpla yung merkado, itong mga downtrend na stocks yung unang tinatamaan. So next on our watch list would be DNL, no? Finally, it break yung critical level. I think this is already turning into a bullish pace. Itong 1130-1140 area. But at this point in time, since the breakout at this point, medyo malaki na rin and extended na yung movement, and baka mag-fade to dito sa area na to. Ang gusto ko sana natin mangyari, if this is truly a bullish stock, no? If not, partial position ka rito, and then titingnan natin kung mag-ano siya, magra-rally pa rin siya beyond this point sa 1130-1140. Partial lang, and then kasi baka mag-retest din to, no? Same thing, and mapapansin nyo naman yung mga place natin ngayon is we're looking for retest and may mga confirmation because of the recent market, no? If kung bullish na bullish talaga tayo, we're going to buy talaga rito, eh, no? Sa level na to, but with the recent market development, we might want to settle for a retest. Or kung wala kang oras or medyo inip ka for a retest, at least buy small portion here. And para ma-obserbahan mo, ma-determine mo kung ano yung mga mangyayari. Alright, so pagdating dito sa ating mga tag dito, the stocks that we're currently looking at. Oh, so mas effective siya Monday, Tuesday, and then as the week progress during Thursday, Friday, mas lumalayo na nang lumalayo yung forecast natin. Right? So laging ganoon naman, you know, the more you are going to project in the future, mas nagiging inaccurate, no? So 1 month from now, mas lalong mahirap i-anticipate 'yon. Lalo pat kung 3 months, mas lalong lalo kung 1 year. Right? So that is the basic, no? Pagdating din sa price action, yung time component niya. The longer you are going to project yung inyong anticipation, lalong mas mahirap and lalong mas lumalaki yung inaccuracy. Right? So gusto ko man sana na maging day-to-day yung ating review. But this, maniwala kayo, this took time. And buti nga't naisisingit ko pa ngayon. Right? So again, last on our watch list is SLI. No? Very, very unfortunate itong SLI because really bullish dito sa SLI with the multi-year high. Mapapansin nyo naman, yung the long-term trend is maganda. But nagkaroon ng exhaustion dito. I think you have at least 3 days, no? Para makawala dito sa at least to lighten up the position. And then from what we're seeing, that is fear, right? So marami yung talagang traders na nandito, na nung last Friday they want to get out. Kaya yan, medyo nagkaroon pa ng gap down. Right? So what do with this scenario? Ganyan talaga. Alright, if this is a trap, no? I mean by a trap, gusto nila i-shake out yung mga retailers. They should close very tightly on Monday and Tuesday. And dapat, no? Makita natin na magkaroon ng stabilization yung kanyang presyo because medyo ano ngayon, medyo itong candle na to mahirap sabayan to eh. If you're not doing intraday, medyo mahihirapan ka rito. Right? On the flip side, this is a multi-year high and the deal happens yung 120 area which is I think we're 9 to 10% away. So at least nandoon yung mga solid na talagang fair value na tinatawag natin. Yun yung inyong magiging cushion, no? If you're going to buy at least dun sa area na yon para kasabay mo yung mga institution. Again, guys, maraming salamat sa panonood and mapapansin nyo, meron tayong mga commercial, you might want to view them, no? At least para magkaroon tayo ng budget, baka pwede natin yung iparapol. Right? Alright, so again, maganda idea yan. If you have any book or trading books na nasa sa isip nyo and magkaroon tayo ng budget, you might want to suggest and then yun yung paparapol natin. Alright guys, maraming salamat sa panonood. This is PSI Recap.